Throwing now, Lawrence on first down. That one complete downfield to Kirk. Touchdown, Jaguars! Christian Kirk, 48 yards! And the Jaguars have taken the lead.
As a fan, is there anything prettier than a well-executed post-snap?
No, it's a thing of beauty, especially when it's done like that for a touchdown.
How about the throw, the catch, and how about the run after to get it to the end zone?
McManus's point after is good, and that makes the score 14-7. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he'll wind up getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble of bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27. Now a timeout called for by the offense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. The Charger drive about to get going. On first and 10, Herbert. And that's going to be incomplete.
Well, they certainly came out firing in this one, and while that one was incomplete, I can't imagine that would be the last shot that they take in this game.
Second and 10. Here's Herbert. And that one complete downfield to Allen. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. That one good for 37 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Herbert now. Trying to force it to Allen, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Tyson Campbell. And the Jags are going to take over once again at their own 25-yard line.
And when I looked down, he was kind of shaking his head right after he threw that pass. What did you see?
Well, from a defense's perspective, anytime you have your eyes back towards the quarterback, you're in a position to make a play on the ball, whether it's a big-time play by you or an overthrow by the quarterback. You have a much better opportunity.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
I like the call. It looked like the right time to dial up a running back screen, but this one got disrupted right from the start and ends up falling incomplete.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25.
Think right open, open.
Looking to throw, Lawrence. Chargers able to get the pressure and bring him down. They'll wind up losing 10 on the sack, and it'll lead to a third and long.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
Second quarter now from Jacksonville, and it's the Jags with the football, as they've got it with a third down and long coming up.
Hey, easy, Ralph, 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 Ralph. 11, Agat. 11, Agat. 11, 11.
Now Lawrence. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Finally, this defense makes a stand. They've given up touchdowns on their first two drives, but here they said, we've got to put a stop to that. Good coverage there to force a punting situation and a fourth down.
So on fourth down, here's Logan Cook to punt for Jacksonville. Deep to return is Darius Davis.
This is fielded at the 27. And that's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done.
And it will be first and 10 as they take over.
The Charger drive about to get going.
Been a little bit of an interesting start. The first drive for him, Charles, they had the passing touchdown. The second drive, he threw the interception. So we'll see what this third drive of the ball game brings.
Yeah, it's kind of a tiebreaker, isn't it? I mean, that's a tough part for them and for him because, yeah, things went really well on that first one, not so well on the second one. He wants to get back to what he did to get this game going. This is going to be a corner route to their tight end, and I'll tell you what, it's man coverage, so that makes it hard for a linebacker to stay with it. And he's able to make the catch on the right side of the field and pick up the first down.
Herbert setting up to throw on first down. Throws left side, complete to Keenan Allen. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 34. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. On first down, it's Herbert. Allen has it left side. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. It's another first down as they look his way again, this time 19 yards.
My goodness, they've come out locked in on this drive. Play calling, execution, they are fully in sync. Three straight passes, three first downs. They're moving the ball downfield almost at will. This defense really struggling to find answers.
Herbert operating from the red zone. He finds his receiver, Williams, for a Charger touchdown.
Mike Williams.
Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Chargers are within an extra point of tying up this ball game. Well, only the two catches for him thus far, CD, but both of them have resulted in touchdowns.
And I think he's on the bench right now, Brandon, smiling at his position coach and telling him, all those times you talked to us about efficiency, I'm living it right now.
Extra point up and good by Dicker,
and we are tied at 14. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. Jamal Agnew now to return it. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive.
As we eat closer and closer to intermission, Charles, remember last time out they punted. They would love to get points here, especially if this is going to be their final possession of the first half.
Yeah, and this is what close games feel like because the pressure is on both sides, but sometimes the pressure is a little bit higher on the team with the slight edge because they're trying to hold on to that, trying to increase it. Let's see how this one continues.
He released that awkwardly. It almost looked like a pitcher who gripped his fastball a little too hard and let it go late and it bounced in front of the plate.
Yeah, one of those fastballs that ends up at 57 feet, not 60 feet, 6 inches. Just a little short with the arm, which is unusual because we saw him in warm-ups. He's got a big, strong arm when he delivers it with confidence.
Here's Lawrence.
Caught on the right side by Jones. He'll be marked down at the 26 with a gain of 7.
That's a gain of 7. Brings up third and 3.
Lawrence on third down.
And that is incomplete.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field is pumped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
Now the offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on 4th and 3.
And they'll try and throw for it with Lawrence.
He's got his target. That's complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 21 yards there. A big play on fourth down.
We always talk about big-time players make big-time plays and big-time moments. I think that fourth down qualified. That was a heck of a throw.
Hey, I'm gone, 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 gone.
On first down, Lawrence. Complete to Jones. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays. Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Lawrence will throw. That's caught by his tight end, Evan Ingram. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. Motion man left is Kirk.
Take right open, open.
On first and 10, it's Lawrence. This is caught, it's Kirk. And they work this near the 5, will be stopped at the 6. Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down.
Think right.
On play action, Lawrence sliding out of the pocket. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. A big loss there of about 7 yards on first and goal, so now it's second down.
First and goal looked like things were set up nicely, and now all of a sudden on second and goal, Charles, a big challenge ahead of them.
And you have to know when you're this close to the goal line, things are going to happen faster, so you've got to get the ball out quick. Not going to have much time in the pocket before the defenders bring pressure.
Now Lawrence. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. And the Chargers are going to get the football here as he gets this up past the 20-yard line.
Well, I would guess that combined, if you spoke to both defenses, neither side has a lot to celebrate today. They haven't had a lot of stops, but that one right there, that's a big one because they stole points away with that play, and just as importantly, picked up a key stop on an offense that's been really impressive here in the early going.
The Charger drive about to get going as they take over with exactly 1 minute to go here before intermission. After the turnover, here's Herbert. He finds his target, Allen. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. Herbert on first down now. Throwing left sideline there, but it's incomplete.
Right up to that point, I was about to say, he's had a pretty good half catching the football, but let's just be honest about it. He should have caught that one.
And he knows that. That was one right in his breadbasket and one he normally catches. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. Herbert. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Now it's Herbert. Pass to the sideline and pulled in. And he'll be touched down here, but not before he does pick up the first. Chargers going to use their third and final timeout as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one. On first down, Justin Herbert. He'll get this out wide to Eckler. So the completion gets him just a yard, and that will bring up second down. The final shot before the break for Herbert. Uncorks one for Davis. And this will be caught in the end zone for a Chargers touchdown. Darius Davis as time expires in the first half. And the Chargers have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half. And just before the half ends, the prayer is answered defensively. A disaster there.
I know often we're surprised when this actually works. I mean, the excitement level goes way up, but maybe we shouldn't be, because I know as a defender, you've got to play the ball in this situation, but you can't interfere with the receiver because, remember, it's a spot foul, and it'd be first and goal if it happens in the end zone, and you don't want to give up that play, and that little bit of hesitancy often works really well for offensive guys.
Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three.
Brandon McManus to kick off for the Jaguars.
So the Chargers will start the second half with the lead and the football as we're underway in the third quarter. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
At their own 19-yard line.
The Charger drive about to get going. As this offense takes the field to begin the opening drive of the second half, Charles, remember that first half, good through the air and really all around an outstanding offensive performance.
Absolutely. They reached the end zone several times. The passing game working awfully well, and most importantly, partner.
Yeah, they went to the tunnel with a lead. They come back out with that lead.
Absolutely. NFL coaches, we know they're perfectionists in a lot of ways, but they had to like what they saw in that first half.
Now a deep ball here, hauled in just past the 50. That one covers 29 yards. First down.
First down, Charger.
Herbert will give this one to Eckler. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Hey, ram, ram, ram.
Play action this time for Justin Herbert. And the Jags get to him as Day goes. Finally hauled down for the first time this game. Multiple defenders in there to drop him.
And they visited the end zone frequently in this one, and obviously they wanted another one. But give credit to the defense there. They may not make the comeback, but pride showed. Good sack on that play.
Gonna throw on third down with Herbert.
So many times we look at the opening drive of the third quarter as a tone setter, and many coaches do emphasize it, and that's a strong performance there defensively to force incompletion and, more importantly, force a quick punting situation.
Here we go on fourth, Herbert.
And Allen's got it!
And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. So after the big play on fourth, here's first and 10. Herbert now. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10. Herbert back to the air. Touchdown! Gerald Everett, 23 yards for the touchdown. And the Chargers take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Circle that drive, because that might be one to remember. Well executed to give him a little cushion.
Well, let's take it into the boxing ring. You talk about them commanding it, keeping the fight where they wanted to, whether it was in the center of the ring or putting them on the ropes, because it was jab, jab, jab. And finally, the haymaker to put that drive away.
Extra point up and good by Dicker. And the lead now up to 14. So after the touchdown, here's Dicker out to kick this one off. Taken at the goal line. Sheds off the tackle. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee, as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They make their second half debut here, and things are looking a little bit tougher now. You give up the points there, Charles, that touchdown drive on the other side. So now it's a two-score game here. Got to be careful.
They certainly do, and I'm just wondering at halftime if those guys just looked into each other's eyes and realized what they've got to get done and come out a little bit more charged up, because they don't get some kind of points here.
And now off to the races, down the right side. And he's going to get this down inside the 40 before he's finally ridden out of bounds. It's a big play for the Jaguars. 48 yards. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10.
Easy. Read a 44. Read a 54. Here we go.
From the gun, it's Lawrence. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
11. Out of the gun, it's Lawrence. And that is caught. It's Ridley. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. Well, make that now two completions for him on this drive, and these aren't ordinary completions. They're big ones.
Yeah, these are the types that make a secondary talk to each other, and not in a good way. Oftentimes pointing fingers. Hey, who's got him? Someone cover him. That type of indecision can open up to even more big plays.
So three plays already, first and goal, and they are wasting little time. And they'll run with ETN. And they'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Jacksonville. Travis ETN, his second touchdown of the night. And the Jaguars are able to cut into this deficit here in the final minute of the third. Well, they move the ball down the field through the air, Charles, and then finally they get the running game involved, and it works to perfection. Touchdown.
And, partner, I kept waiting for that running game to come into play and actually saved it until the very end. Touchdown goes on his stat sheet, but you and I both know, and he knows as well, his teammates airing it out made this a successful drive.
13, Luke. 11.
Lawrence going to look to throw for it. And now the pressure gets there, and he goes down. So he couldn't get rid of the football, and that deficit stays right where it is. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. The Charger drive about to get going. Now they've got the lead here getting late into the third quarter. And the passing game for them, it's been terrific. We've seen that, but the rushing game, almost non-existent.
And with the lead and trying to finish this game off.
And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, LA. Mike Williams, 82 yards. And the Chargers will add on to their lead here in the final minute of the third.
Extra point up and good by Dicker. And the lead is up to 15 now.
Cameron Dicker to kick off for the Chargers.
Now after the Dicker field goal, he's back out ready to send it away.
To return, here's Agnew.
And he'll go down at the 2-yard line. What a disaster there.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. Lawrence from his end zone. A short throw to Ingram. And he's able to get him a small cushion before being taken down at the 5, a gain of 3. He's been quiet today in the passing game, just his second catch.
Yeah, and people have to come up with schemes to limit him. And what a lot of teams do, they'll double him, you know, use a linebacker underneath, a safety over the top. Sometimes they'll just take a corner, maybe their third corner if he's a bigger guy, and put him on a man-to-man to try and limit his touches. Just keep mixing it up, give him different angles, different looks, like a good boxer does.
And he'll take this across the 25 before going out of bounds. Three quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. In motion left goes a tight end.
11, Agnew.
Now Lawrence on first down. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
We just saw another example of really good defensive football, which has led to the cushion that they have in this game. Got to him once again, knocked him on the ground, forced an incompletion.
Yeah, they've set the tone. It's one thing to set the tone, another to come in here on the road and set the tone. Again, it's Lawrence. And that is incomplete. Nearly intercepted. The free safety couldn't quite get his hands around it, and it brings up third down.
Hey, run! Heavy, heavy.
Here's Lawrence. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he is going to have a Jags first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. So after two first downs, they get another here. First and 10 at the 45. Motion man left is Kirk.
Hey, kill.
On first down, Lawrence. He completes it to Ridley. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup. Defensively here, you've got the cushion, but back-to-back pretty big pass plays there. Bend but don't break, but are they bending too much?
I think that they are. To me, it'd be like playing basketball, and you put up a token press. Make sure you get up there and make them eat up some time. Make it a little bit of resistance so they can't just run it right down your throat.
Oh, it's intercepted. A drive killer there. Picked off by Asante Samuel Jr. And the Chargers are going to get the football back at their own 17. With the points that we've seen scored, neither defense has been at their best.
Go that, please, please don't. Go that, go that, go that. leave when they jump in the front seat to play with the speakers.